Air Marshal Dr. Lalji K. Verma is going to speak to us on hospital waste management. Air Marshal Lalji K. Verma was former Director General of the Medical Services Indian Air Force. He is the founder president of the Indian Society of Hospital Waste Management, and in addition to a degree of MBBS, he has done an MSc in Ecology and Environment and a PhD in Hospital Waste Management. He is a member of various centers, the India International Center, the Consultancy Developmental Center, and member of the International Solid Waste Association. He's received an honorary fellowship of the Indian Society of Aerospace Medicine and is a founding fellow of the Indian Society of Hospital Waste Management. He's written books. He's written a book called Managing Healthcare Waste, and two books containing his articles and papers have been recently published by Lambert Academic Publishing. Over to Air Marshal Dr. Lalji K. Verma.
Thank you, Chair. Thank you, Madam, very much. My talk basically is centered towards hospital waste management, which I think is an important area of total patient care. But before I start the presentation, I must take this opportunity to thank the organizers for having invited me here for this talk. And I always admire this place, the hospital as well as the college, for basically two things. One is simplicity, and second is excellent professionalism. Professional excellence. So simplicity with professional excellence is possible and is being demonstrated. In fact, Vellore Hospital and College, I should say, that should be an icon for demonstrating to the world that simplicity with professional excellence is possible, and it is very much there on the ground. Having said that, now two things. One is that my talk is basically not centered towards a particular hospital or towards any facet of healthcare delivery, but it is overall, it's a overall holistic view. As far as the hospital waste management is concerned, I think most of you are familiar with the rules, etc. The basic aim is to safeguard healthcare worker infection control, reduce, recycle, reuse, and recover. These are the four R's which must be practiced, or at least tried to practice it. System approach is very much important, because most of the places, what I have seen in my work on this area, is that people think that once you have gotten a particular equipment, maybe a hydroclave, maybe a microwave, maybe an incinerator, or whatever it is, the job is done. It's not so. The infection control, the basic fact is that hospital waste management is a part of infection control. It must work in synergy with infection control. And therefore, there is a requirement of developing a system in the hospitals by which you achieve this waste management as well as help towards infection control and patient safety and worker safety. There are on-site, off-site treatment and disposal systems. There are certain equipments. There are common biomedical waste facility systems, which are about 150 in India now and located at different places. Waste management plan in a hospital should be attempted as a development of a system. I would like to re-emphasize this. And including, it includes education and awareness, safety issue risk management, plan to develop and practice 4 R's, and focus on societal responsibility. That is very important, because even if one meets the mandate of the rules and law, there should be one thing in your mind always, that what kind of a societal responsibility do you bear as a healthcare provider, and what kind of societal responsibilities you are performing as a healthcare provider. And in case the waste from the hospital is infected and infectious, and it's going out and mixing with the municipal waste, I would say that the hospital is not not keeping this in mind, that is the societal responsibility. Now, first, environment. What is environment? Basically, it's not a constant factor. It is a dynamic equilibrium which is maintained between the different parts of environment, including the species, either animate or inanimate. So that is what is environment, and it keeps on changing. But it has got a firm relationship. And the human being is a very, very important part of this environment, and we should not do anything by which we can harm the we would harm the environment. And as far as health is concerned, this is the WHO definition, except what is written in the red, and that is where I have been advocating and also submitting to different people that we must introduce this environmental pollution into the overall total health concept. What is waste is an unwanted product, there is no doubt about it, but it can be used, it can be recycled, it can be reused by some other agency. It contains, as far as hospital waste is concerned, you know, it contains infectious waste, hazardous waste, and it should be considered as an extended responsibility of the healthcare provider. The patient care does not end where you give medicine, patient becomes all right and he goes. I think it's very important to include the waste management as a part of total healthcare, because whatever has been generated in a house, one should be prepared to clean it up by whatever means, or make it non-hazardous, make it non-infectious. So that is what is most important to understand. And I think a lot of you may be aware of this, that Basel Convention has declared healthcare waste as the second most hazardous waste after the radioactive waste. There are, since the time is limited, so I have just selected that, you know, issues and concerns I will deal with. And there are issues and concerns as far as waste management is concerned. There are many issues. One is legislative, then monitoring issues are there, implementation issues are there, awareness issues are there, and safety issues are there. In the legislative issue, basically, you have a scenario where the rules have been promulgated by the Ministry of Environment and Forest, and the implementation is at the hospital level. The Ministry of Environment and Forest in most of the states, all the states, are represented by the pollution control boards. They come inspect the hospital, advise them what to do as far as the end products are concerned. But they have no wherewithal, or they have no knowledge how to advise the patient with regard to infection control. And infection control is a process by itself. It is not an end of pipeline solution. Therefore, it is very important to understand this kind of a dichotomy which has taken place. In fact, left to me, I would like to recommend that there should be a parallel policy document which should be issued by the health departments and health ministry. Monitoring issues, as I told you, the monitoring is by pollution control boards and committees. They come and check the stack, they come and check the bacterial end products, etc. But what is required is, they also, I do not know if they check the safety requirements or not. Do they check the safety equipment which are being used by the hospital? Do they check the safety clothing which are supposed to be used by the waste handlers? I do not really know. But whatever I have known, looking at places like Delhi, Jharkhand, etc., I think that the Pollution Control Board is just not concerned about that. They just come and thereafter they see if there is an incinerator, they take the air sampling from the incinerator, and thereafter they say, this is what is wrong, that is what is wrong, etc. And the hospital has to take the brunt, and they have to do whatever is possible within their own budgetary allocation, etc. And therefore, the what comes from the pollution board is from one particular administrative tree. What should go from the hospital, their difficulties, etc., that goes into another administrative tree, that is the health department. And therefore, there is a dichotomy, and this must be addressed too. There should be a proper coordination between Ministry of Environment and Forest and Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, and there should be coordination between pollution control boards and health department. Implementation, I would say that it will include, it should include 100% capture, proper disinfection according to whatever protocol the hospital may have laid down, and then mutilation after disinfection, plastic syringes, etc., must be mutilated so that it doesn't come back into the circulation. There are many places and there are many examples where one has found that the plastic syringes has been reused, and that has caused a lot of problems. There should be a movement as per plan. In fact, the standard operating procedure should be developed in each hospital, which should be specific to hospital, and it should also be specific to the departments. And so hospital is specific and department is specific. Standard operating procedure, as far as the waste management is concerned, that should be developed. And there should be a terminal treatment by which you disinfect the different categories of waste, and then there should be a final disposal and process. Disposal is disposal as well as process. Final disposal as well as process is some step where beyond which you don't have to really do any intervention. But why we should be concerned, that's also a point. I was talking about the recirculation of non-disinfected plastic syringes, which happened in Modasa, Gujarat, and I think that is not very old. 59 people or 58 people, they died because of hepatitis B in epidemic. Then similarly, Health Minister of Delhi, she went visiting some of the hospitals quite some time ago, and she says, what I saw at Lok Nayak Hospital, since she has named the hospital, so therefore I have no qualms about naming the hospital, was horrifying. There was no system of disposal of needles, even in AIDS clinic. All the basic lessons of hospital waste disposal had been thrown to the winds there. And therefore we should be concerned. Now you know that chemical pollution in the healthcare waste can affect the health of an individual. If it is, you know, mercury, then it crosses the blood-brain barrier, it crosses the placental barrier. And as you know, the children are more vulnerable to chemical pollution because their BMR is higher and they inhale air as well as food in higher proportion than the adults. Unsafe injections are known to cause many communicable and infectious diseases. And WHO has done a study, which is a voluminous book form, where they have come with details that disease-adjusted life years, that is DALYs, is about 4 million in Southeast Asia region, and yearly burden, it amounts to yearly burden of about, at that time, $535 million, and this report is volume 77, which is perhaps about 10 years old or so. And we also undertake immunization program, and in that immunization program you can just imagine that so much of plastic syringes are generated, waste are generated, that it will be difficult for, unless we take care of it, it will be very difficult in the future. There are three types of equipment in the waste management: ancillary equipment, which are normally, you know, help, they help the main treatment. Then you've got terminal treatment options, which are you know, listed there. Then you've got final disposal in the processes. Then the current picture, I would just, there are so many places where survey has been done and there are reports available, but only one I will place in front of you because of paucity of time. And that is, it was undertaken in 2007. And this is what it shows, that as far as water, wastewater is concerned, disposal of methods, infectious waste, wastewater is concerned, is 100% without any treatment. And similarly, you can see other wastes also, most of it is not being treated. Then you have got disinfected, the waste which has been disinfected with sodium hypochlorite solution is very small, incineration is small, and given to service provider, those who are, you know, operating the common biomedical waste facility, in a large proportion, without any kind of a disinfection, without any kind of a, and segregation is also poor. And therefore, it causes a lot of problem with the common biomedical waste facility operator. Similarly, lab waste, you can see, most of it was given without any disinfection. Then a lot of people, they were used puncture-proof containers for sharps, 81.20%, and this was done, this survey was done for small hospitals and nursing homes in Delhi. These are the common observation and impressions. There are hospitals use three bin system, but there were deficiencies. Standard procedure for quantification of waste was deficient at most of the hospitals. That means they did not really quantify, they just did a guesswork. And similarly, you know, proper records were not maintained, accident reporting was not there, segregation was found not satisfactory. Most of the hospitals lacked system development for infection control and safety. And most importantly, there was no SOP which was available in any of the nursing homes and hospitals, including the 10 government hospitals which we surveyed year before, in 2010, I think, 2010. So this was done as a government-aided project, and we did this 10 hospitals there, and we found, I would say that very disappointing picture it presented in front of us. And the most important was that in these hospitals, the waste handlers are changed daily. That means they are considered as a daily laborer, and if one person comes today, he will not be seen tomorrow, because the contract has been given to a contractor who brings the daily laborer. And that scenario is something which nobody with any kind of a scientific mind can digest. So there were deficits, lack of safety precautionary measures, absence of waste management committee in most of the healthcare facilities. And this waste management committee must work in coordination with the infection control committee, and that is most important to understand. Lack of coordination, then defective shafts management, no waste water management, healthcare waste management in rural areas. What do we do for that? We have not even gone one step beyond what to do for rural healthcare. So just to say a few words with regard to how to lay down a waste management plan, these are the steps where one must do right from the beginning, like baseline survey, healthcare facilities specific protocols. These are the steps, and it must one must go stepwise to ultimately make a proper standing operating procedure for the hospital. Source separation is one of the most important parts of waste management, and there are four cardinal principles in the healthcare waste management which must be followed. One is disinfection nearest to the point of generation, mutilation at the earliest opportunity. Involved process of healthcare waste does not do any harm to the environment or the individual, and a solution doesn't become a problem in later years. And then practice waste minimization, resource source reduction, and you know, 4 R's which I have just mentioned earlier. There are awareness issues, training program and awareness issues. Training program is not regular in most of the hospitals. Once in a while, perhaps a seminar, workshop, etc. is held, but it's not regular in most of the hospitals. So what are the challenges? How to make the legislators appear, appreciate the problem, because they are the fund provider basically, and be more proactive. How to remove dichotomy in legislation? How to make awareness campaign more effective? Awareness amongst doctors, nurses, housekeeping staff, and most importantly, the waste handlers, how to make it effective and regular? How to bring about more effective monitoring? And now, it's just for information, apart from the rules being reviewed by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, there is a parliamentary committee also, which has been constituted. And there was a newspaper item, and we have submitted our comments on that. And therefore, in summary, I would like to say that tasks are that we should develop a specific protocol, we should develop segregation practices, disinfection practices, shafts management, worker safety we should take into account, precautionary measures, risk management is also an important part, reduce, reuse, recycle, and recover. Standards for monitoring must be stated, and audit, waste audit should be done, where you will come to know how much is the deficiency, how much waste was generated, how much waste has been taken care of. And then material and supply chain management, which is also very important, right from obtaining the medicines to issuing it to the patients. And of course, cost benefit analysis should be done after some time, and impact assessment. So the drivers are training, awareness, political will, policy, budget, public pressure. I consider that we are the public and we are putting pressure. So I would request the hospitals to take this into account. Then monitoring and evaluation, research and development, which is very important, it's very badly lacking in any sphere. There is hardly any research and development in the country. In fact, I will just cite an example, if I may, that say, for example, you have got known chemical pollutants in the water, and we are all ingesting. How much mercury I am carrying, I don't know. So unless a person becomes a patient, and when he goes to the hospital, then you can say that he is a case of mercury poisoning. But without that, you will not be able to say that he has got a mercury poisoning. Whereas a lot of research on this has been done in the United States, and there are references and books available on this. ICMR should undertake a research project on this, that how much of pollution, pollutant, one carries in the body today. Not only mercury, there are so many others. And then the aim basically should be only safe disposal, not adverse to human health, not adverse to environment. And conclusion, 21st century is going to be a challenge to human existence, waste being a major adverse factor in the quest for sustainable development and existence. Thank you.